Okay, so in our previous lesson, we have done nomenclature, we did all the introduction of the amines. Let's go on to the chemical properties of amines. Now, when we're talking of amines, the most important property of amines over here, that is going to be the basic nature of amines, right? We know that ammonia is basic in nature. Why ammonia is basic? The reason behind that is that it has a lone pair of electrons, so it is going to behave as a Lewis base. Okay? In a similar manner, when we're looking at the structure of amines, it is seen that all the amines, they are going to have a lone pair of electrons, which it can easily donate, and as a result of which they are going to behave as amines, right? So they are also going to behave as, you can say, as Lewis bases. Now, the amines, they are going to be weak bases over here. As they are going to react with water to give us hydroxyl ions. So, when we are looking at the reaction, let's say that this is an amine reacting with water. This is going to give us RNH3 positive plus OH negative. Now, applying the law of mass action, what are we going to get? KB for the reaction, that is going to be concentration of RNH3 positive into concentration of OH negative upon concentration of RNH2, that is going to be the value of KB. Over here, the concentration of water, that is going to be taken as constant. Now, all those which generally have a higher value of KB, they are going to be stronger bases, right? So, this we already know. Now, the basic strength that can also be exhibited in the form of pKb values, where this pKb values, that is going to be equal to minus log of Kb. Okay? So, ye kya ho jayega? Agar aap bol rahe, greater the value of Kb, more is going to be the basic character. In a similar manner, lesser the value of pKb, that is going to be more basic. Right? Larger the value of pKb, weaker is the base. Smaller the value of pKb, stronger is the base. Okay? Now, when we're talking of comparison of basic strength, let's compare the basic strength of ammonia . The first one which we are going to compare over here, that is the basic strength of ammonia and amines, right? In general, both are going to behave as bases due to their tendency to donate the lone pair of electrons. Now, over here to see that the amines, they are going to be more basic. Let's see how, when we're talking of nitrogen in terms of ammonia over here, ammonia is going to behave as a base because it has a tendency to give this lone pair of electrons, right? Now, if we are taking the case of a primary amine over here, now this alkyl group, due to its plus I effect, that is positive inductive effect, it will have a tendency to donate the lone pair of electrons on nitrogen, as a result of which the electron density of nitrogen will increase and the electrons, they can be easily removed. Therefore, the alkyl amines, they are going to be stronger bases with respect to ammonia. Now, let's over here try and compare the 1 degree, 2 degree and 3 degree amines also. Now, in case of ammonia, if we're looking at the structure, this is how we can draw the structure. In case of primary amine, there is going to be one alkyl group present. Okay? In case of secondary amines, there are going to be two alkyl group present. And in case of tertiary amines, there are going to be three alkyl group present. Now, over here, this one alkyl group is going to give its electrons on nitrogen, as a result of which the electron density will increase and the basic character will also increase. In case of secondary, there are two alkyl groups, okay? Because of these two alkyl groups, again, what is going to happen? The electron density will increase further and the basic character should increase, ठीक है. नाउ इफ देयर आर थ्री एंकाइल ग्रुप्स ओवर हियर द बेसिक कैरेक्टर विल स्टिल इंक्रीज राइट इट शुड स्टिल इंक्रीज सो अकॉर्डिंग टू इफ यू आर ओनली टेकिंग इनटू कंसीडरेशन द प्लासा इफेक्ट अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट द टर्शियरी अमीन्स शुड बी मोस्ट बेसिक ड्यू टू द प्लासा इफेक्ट देन इट शुड बी 2 डिग्री अमीन्स देन इट शुड बी 1 डिग्री अमीन्स. Now this is true in case of gaseous phase. So we are taking the trend of basic strength in terms of gaseous phase. Then this trend, that is 3 degree is more basic than 2 degree is more basic than 1 degree. That is going to be true. But if we are taking aqueous phase, we will see that the order of basic strength followed will not be the same as it is followed in gaseous phase. So let's see what is going to be the difference over here. Okay. Now when we're talking in aqueous phase, in case of aqueous phase, it is seen that the trend which is going to be followed, that is going to be 2 degree is going to be more basic than 1 degree is going to be more basic than 3 degree. And this is the trend followed if the alkyl group is a smaller group like the methyl group. So if you're taking methyl secondary, ठीक है, 2 degree methyl amine, that is going to be more basic than methanamine, and that is going to be more basic than NN dimethyl methanamine, right? But if there's going to be a bulkier group present, like for example, if instead of methyl group we are having ethyl group, so in that case the trend follow is going to be different. What is going to be the trend in case of C2H5? Secondary is going to be most basic, then it is going to be tertiary instead of primary, and then the least basic over here, that is going to be 1 degree. Now let's understand why this is happening over here, why the trend is not the same as which is followed in the gaseous phase, or why the trend changes when we are using the bulkier groups, right? Now in this case, when we're talking of the basic strength in aqueous solutions, that is going to depend upon two factors. The first one, which is known as the steric factor, and the second one, which is known as the hydration effect. Now, this is a very, very important concept from this chapter, because always we predict one question from this section. Okay, so we're talking of paper of 2000, question paper of 2017 boards, we've got one question from this section. And also when we're talking of competitions, this is the trend which is going to come. Okay, what is going to be the basic strength of the following? So, aapko yaad rakhna hai, in case the group is methyl group, then in that case, 2 degree is more basic than 1 degree is more basic than 3 degree. But if we are taking larger groups than the methyl group, then the trend is going to be 2 degree is more basic than 3 degree is more basic than 1 degree. Theek hai? Now, over here, when we are talking of the first kind of effect, that is the steric hindrance or the steric effect. Over here, basically, alright, let's say we are taking an example of tertiary over here. ठीक है? अब क्या होगा कि all these three alkyl groups, they are going to be bigger groups. As a result, they are going to crowd around nitrogen. Right? So, we can say that these have a tendency to cover the nitrogen. As they cover the nitrogen from all the three sides, this will make the incoming species, which is positively charged and which wants to form a bond with these two lone pair of electrons, this lone pair of electrons which is present over here, that is going to become difficult. Okay? So the approaching element or approaching group of species that is going to find it difficult to come nearer to nitrogen, as a result of which in higher cases, what is going to happen when the alkyl group that is going to be larger, then the basic character should be minimum. ठीक है? So this is one thing. Then over here, but it is not only the steric effect which is going to affect the basic strength over here. It is also going to be the hydration effect and the combination of three different effects. That is the plasma effect, the steric effect, and the hydration effect. They are going to give us finally these strengths. So let's understand over here what the hydration effect is. When we taking the hydration effect. The hydration effect that will depend or the stability of the conjugated acid that is going to depend on the fact that how easily the proton that is being accepted from the solution. Okay, so let's talk of first of all the primary. In case of primary, there are going to be two hydrogens which are present. ठीक है, सो हमने एक्वस में डाला इसको, एक्वस से दिस विल हैव अ टेंडेंसी टू एक्सेप्ट द हाइड्रोजन, राइट? सो दिस एक्सेप्ट्स द हाइड्रोजन टू गिव अस अ कंजुगेटेड एसिड ओवर हियर, राइट? नाउ एज यू कैन सी ओवर हियर देयर आर गोइंग टू बी थ्री हाइड्रोजन्स व्हिच आर प्रेजेंट. ऑल दीस थ्री हाइड्रोजन्स दे कैन वेरी इजीली फॉर्म हाइड्रोजन बॉन्ड्स विद वाटर. It is forming hydrogen bond with water over here, then this hydrogen also, and this hydrogen also. Okay, now let's go on to the secondary. This is the secondary one. H over here, right? Now over here the protonated acid which we are going to get is going to have two hydrogens. So we have R, N, H, H and H. Let's put a positive charge on nitrogen over here, right? Now here we have what is there? We have an alkyl group. So we have only two hydrogens which can form hydrogen bonds in the water. Right, so the size over here that is going to decrease. What will we get? So you can see that the size decreases. Right, now when we talking of tertiary, in case of tertiary, there's going to be only one hydrogen present in the protonated acid. Okay? Now this is going to form very less hydrogen bond and the size will still decrease further. Greater than 1 degree. Okay, now taking into atmospheric hindrance factors. This is going to determine the stability of the ammonium cation in solution, and therefore the trend given is 2 degree greater than 3 degree greater than 1 degree. Okay? So this is going to be the basic strength in case of aqueous solutions. But please remember कि alkyl group कौन सा दिया है, उसके basis पे फिर ये trend आपका change हो जाता है. मिथाइल अमीन में और इथाइल अमीन में देयर इज गोइंग टू बी अ चेंज, राइट? सो दिस इज अ कंपैरेटिव स्टडी ऑफ बेसिक स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ अमीन्स. लेट्स गो ऑन टू द कंपैरेटिव स्टडी ऑफ बेसिक स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ एरोमेटिक अमीन्स एंड एलिफैटिक अमीन्स. यू शुड रिमेंबर दैट एनिलिन इज लेस बेसिक than ammonia, right? Or even for that matter than amines. The reason behind this is that over here in case of aniline, the lone pair of electrons, they are in conjugation with the benzene ring. ठीक है? So lone pair of electrons over here, they are not easily available for donation. Therefore, this is going to behave as a weak base. Now, this we can explain on looking at the resonating structures over here. Just look at structure number 2, 3 and 4. In all these second, third and fourth structure, there is no lone pair of electron which is present on nitrogen. So as the lone pair of electron that is in conjugation with the benzene ring, it cannot be easily donated. Therefore, aniline that is going to be less basic with respect to ammonia and amines. Then another point which you can remember over here, that when we are taking acetamide is also less basic. Right? Acetamide also, that is not, in fact, you can say why basic, it is not going to show any basic character. The reason behind that is, again, due to resonance, this is acetamide. Now, over here, again, resonance, this structure is going to show resonance. As a result of which the lone pair of electrons are not available at all. So this goes here, the resonating structure strength. because that is the kind of question which is going to come in your competitions. So let's go on to examples of basic strength in decreasing order. Alright, so we're taking examples in decreasing order of basicity of certain molecules. Right? First, we are taking on the basis of hybridization. So we have CH3NH2. Over here, sp3 hybridization is present. This is going to be more basic than CH3N double bond, amines, CH3. So these are amines, these are amines. Yahan pe the hybridization is sp2, yahan pe the hybridization is sp3. So sp3 is going to be more basic. Then the cyano compounds. Okay, so sp jo hai, that is going to be least basic. Right? Clear ho gaya? Another trend which we can do over here, that is we are again taking sp3 hybridization with 3 carbon atoms. sp3 most basic. Phir uske baad if there is a double bond character which is present, so yahan pe hybridization sp2 aa gayi, theek hai. So the basic strength that is going to decrease, and if there is sp hybridization present, this is going to be least basic. If there is a triple bond which is present in the carbon chain, theek hai. Fir uske baad third trend which we are going to do, this is secondary. As we just discussed, secondary that is going to be most basic in case of methyl. Then it is going to be primary. Then it is going to be ammonia. Or tertiary jo yahan pe hoga, wo jo hai, that is going to be less basic. Theek hai? Or ammonia se bhi jo kam basic hai, that is going to be aniline. So ye trends aapne yaad rakhne hai. These are very important when you want to sit for your JEE and your NEET. Theek hai? Fir uske baad another trend which we are going to do over here is the fourth one, that is secondary amine is going to be more basic than N-phenylmethanamine. Right? Which is going to be more basic than aniline. Theek hai? And then finally, fifth, CH3CH2NH2, this is ethanamine, which is going to be more basic than amide, benzamide. This is benzamide, and which is going to be more basic than acetamide. Right? So these are the trends which you need to remember. Now this section over here, the basic strength, this is a very, very, very important sector. Now you really need to study very, very hard or read this in and out from your reference books first. And then of course when you want to summarize, you can go on to the NCRT. But it is very, very important to understand this. Either you can understand this from the lecture which I have taught you, or if you still have certain problems in this, you can read through your book. Okay? So today we are going to do only till here. Tomorrow we go on to general methods of preparations of amines.